प्रियदर्शी का
गुरु ब्रह्मा गुरु विष्णु गुरु देवो महेश्वर गुरु साक्षात् परब्रह्मा तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा। ज्ञानानन्दमयं देवं निर्मलस्फटिकाकृतम् आधारं सर्वविद्यानां हयग्रीवमुपास्महे।
Thank you, Priyadarshika, for your sweet voice of prayer. Now I would like to invite Vishnuram to give the welcome address.
Respected Principal, Vice Principal, esteemed guest of honor, faculty members, and my dear friends, warm greeting to all of you. I am Vishnuram from Third Year Tripoli. Welcome you all to the inauguration of RIT, Electra Student Association and Professional Societies, IE and IEEE. On behalf of the management, faculty members and students, I would like to thank our guest of honor, Mr. K.V. Vinod Kumar, Contracts Manager, Fuels and Lubricants Value Chain, ExxonMobil India Private Limited, for taking his precious time out and gracing the occasion with his presence, who will deliver a lecture on the topic, Design Thinking and Innovation. With these few words, I once again welcome everyone present here for the inaugural function. Thank you.
Thank you, Vishnuram. Now I call upon Sandamarai to give the annual plan of professional societies and association.
Good morning, one and all present here. I am T. Sandamarai from Final Year Tripoli. First, I would like to welcome our distinguished chief guest of today's function, Mr. K. V. Vinod Kumar, Contracts Manager, Fuels and Lubricants Value Chain, ExxonMobil India Private Limited, Bangalore. So, respected Principal Dr. L. Ganesan sir, HOD of our department, Dr. S. Kannan sir, faculty members and my dear friends. It's my privilege to present the annual plan of RIT Electra Technical Association and Professional Society, IEI and IEEE student branch before this gathering. An eventful year lies ahead for the Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering. In continuation of our previous year activities, with a view to increase industry and student interaction, industrial visits have been planned for first year, second year, third year and final year triple students. In order to motivate the students to prepare for GATE and other competitive exams, it has been planned to conduct one technical quiz for third year students and one aptitude test for third year and final year students at frequent intervals. In order to create the social awareness on COVID-19 among students, social awareness program on code preparation against COVID-19 has been planned on 31st August 2020. A guest lecture on renewable energy system has been planned on 5th September 2020 for third year and final year students. This will help the students to get awareness about the recent trends in renewable energy. A workshop on virtual lab has been planned for all EEE students on 6th September 2020. In order to motivate the students to prepare for their placement drive, it has been planned to conduct group discussion for final year students on 13th September 2020. With a view to help the students present papers and gain knowledge, paper presentation event has been planned for all EEE students on 23rd September 2020. To improve the creativity of students and gain knowledge, mnemonic contest and memes contest for all EEE students on 30th September 2020 and 5th October 2020. Contest of pictorial connection has been planned for all EEE students on 12th October 2020. A guest lecture series on recent advancement or state of art technologies has been planned on 20th October 2020 for all third year and final year students of EEE. Workshop on application of artificial intelligence in engineering problems has been planned for all EEE students on 28th and 29th of October 2020. Faculty development program on application of optimization techniques in engineering solutions has been planned for all faculty members and students on 17th and 18th of December 2020. Field visit to Ramco Mills Limited, Rajapalayam has been planned for first year students on 21st December 2020. Field visit to RIT Powerhouse has been planned for second year and third year students on 28th December 2020. Discussion meeting on innovative practices has been planned for all EEE faculty members on 4th January 2021. Awareness program on energy saving and energy safety has been planned for all EEE students on 11th and 21st of January 2021. In order to motivate the social awareness among students, social awareness program on tree plantation has been planned for all EEE students on 22nd January 2021. A seminar on role of IoT in agriculture has been planned for all EEE students on 2nd February 2021. A workshop on Raspberry Pi has been planned for all students in our college on 11th and 12th of February 2021. A drawing competition on green energy generation has been planned for all students in our college on 18th February 2021. In order to motivate the students to do their mini project, project content has been planned for all EEE students on 26th February 2021. A social awareness program on book reading has been planned to conduct for all EEE students on 5th March 2021. A competition on poster presentation of our history of a component has been planned to conduct once in a semester for all EEE students. In order to encourage the students on book reading, book review session has been planned for all EEE students on every Sunday. In order to motivate the students for their placement drive and to know the industrial experience, alumni talk has been planned for all EEE students at frequent intervals. To increase the technical knowledge of all the students, a display of technical information has been planned for all EEE students at frequent intervals. A photographic contest has been planned for all EEE students at frequent intervals. I hope the students would greatly benefit from these events and I wish them a great success. Once again, thanks the department for this opportunity given to present the RIT Electrotechnical Association and Professional Society IEI and IEEE Student Branch annual plan. Thank you.
Thank you, Sundamari, for delivering the plan of annual plan. Now I welcome Abhinaya Sri to give the introduction of the chief guest.
Warm welcome to one and all present here. Myself is S. Abhinaya Sri from second year EEE. It gives me a great privilege to introduce the today's distinguished chief guest to all the participants. Mr. K.V. Vinod Kumar has completed his BE Electrical and Electronics Engineering from Arulmigu Kalasalingam College of Engineering, Madurai Kamaraj University in 2002. He has vast industrial experience of 18 years, out of which 12 years in oil and gas related industries. He started his career as a business development executive in RR Infotech Limited, Chennai. Presently, he is working as a contracts manager, a fuel and lubricant value chain, ExxonMobil India Private Limited, Bangalore. His professional experience comprises of various positions from the reputed companies like ExxonMobil, Shell, McDermott, and Cognizant, etc. He demonstrated consulting and supply chain sourcing strategy solutions across end-to-end CapEx procurement and purchasing or planning professional with extensive experience in supply management. He is responsible for talent hiring, setting up teams, monitoring and motivating them for annual performance plannings, coaching and career development for individual team members. He is passionate about technology trends, market intelligence, data analysis, business strategy and planning, webinar and workshop. His hobby includes traveling, meeting people. With these words, I welcome our chief guest and I hope we will have a great session. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Now I request beloved chief guest to give the guest lecture on design thinking and innovation.
Good morning, everyone. Hope you all can hear me.
Yeah, yes, Vinod Kumar. It is audible.
Can you hear,
yes,
hear me? Okay. Thank you very much. Thanks. Okay. Karthik, can you put this screen on the full size mode? Can you put the slides on the full size mode?
Yes. Now it is okay.
Thank you. Okay. First, I would like to thank. Thanks, Karthik. Yeah, it's fine. First, I would like to thank Ramco Institute of Technology for giving me an amazing opportunity to interact with people like you. Then I would like to thank Mr. Karthikeyan, who has been pioneering this session and who has taken this initiative to invite me and present a topic on design thinking and innovation. Before I go into the slide, I would like to give an introduction, but thank you, Abhineshri, for giving a very detailed introduction about myself. Karthik, can you move on to the next slide?
Next one.
So as she has mentioned, I'm an engineer. Yes, I'm an engineer, electrical and electronics engineer, graduated from Kalasalingam College, which is close to your college near Ramco. I have an industry experience of 18 years, out of which 12 years in oil and gas. I would like to pass over here, and I would like to keep this session more interactive. I want people to ask questions. I want people to throw up their doubts. I want people to come and speak to me. I don't know how many of you have heard about career in oil and gas. If in case you know something about oil and gas, can you please unmute yourself and can you just speak so that I can see what is your understanding in oil and gas and I can speak about how you can build your career in oil and gas before I go into this today's topic. Please unmute yourself if in case you have any doubts. Please unmute yourself if you have any knowledge in oil and gas, please. Okay. I don't think there is so much of a challenge. So basically, after your graduation, our people mindset, because I also graduated from a college like you near from Madurai Kamaraj University. So basically, our mindset now is after we get a graduation, we need to go and work for software. We need to work for companies like Infosys, TCS, CTS, Accenture or something, which is mainly an IT service company. But if you come out of the world, real world, and if you see where do you stand and how you want to progress, there are lots and lots of opportunity apart from IT. So to start with, what I can suggest is don't look into only IT jobs. There are a lot of jobs available in the market. And one such domain is oil and gas. I'm not sure whether there are mechanical engineers in this session, but I would like to stress a point over here. If you are a mechanical engineer, definitely look out for opportunity in oil and gas, because this is a very, very, very good domain where you have an exposure to all the international oil companies around the world, and where do you have a chance to work in all the international locations and oil fields which is located all over the world. So I would take you to take this as a starting point, especially mechanical engineers, to see how you can develop your career in oil and gas. As I also started my career in similar way after completing the graduation, I went to Chennai. I started my career with a small BPO firm, working as a business development executive. Then I went into an IT company called Cognizant, which most of you know. And from there, I took a twist in my career because I don't want to be serving in service industry for long. Because the advantage over the other profession and service industry, or the disadvantages of service industries, is you don't have time. You have a lot of pressure. But when you go into a career in oil and gas, you find definitely yourself more interesting, more innovative, more challenging, and more opportunities to learn. This is where you need to see. So I also took a pass in my career when I worked in Cognizant, and then I started to develop my skill set around oil and gas, and then I started to work for Shell. In 2008, I joined Shell. In Shell, I spent close to 9 years in Shell. Then I moved to McDermott, which is also an US-based oil and gas company in Good Delhi. And from there, I came to Bangalore, back to Bangalore, working for ExxonMobil, which is also the number one oil and gas company based out of Houston in US. So this is where my experience, or where I learned my opportunities. Because if you limit yourself within your service industry or a development industry, definitely you will feel that you are missing a lot of things in the world. And that is where you need to bring the change, or bring the starting up change. There is a good introduction covered on my passionate strength. Yes, the technology trends, what are the technology that's happening in the market intelligence, the data analysis, the business strategy and planning, doing webinars for a lot of colleges, motivating the people to drive their career after their graduation. And then obviously my travel, because as I work in oil and gas, I have traveled to most of the countries, meeting different people of different culture. And at the end, I am married and I have 2 kids. Can you move on to the next slide, Karthik? Okay. So what are you going to learn today? Three things before we end this session. What is design thinking? What are the process behind design thinking? And how you want to be innovative in design thinking, or how you want to develop your skills to design thinking. So these are the key things that you're going to learn. The reason why I took this topic, this is a topic which covers both your professional challenges as well as your personal challenges. In life today, everyone has a lot of problem. COVID is a big problem. Personally, you are facing a lot of stress in COVID. And when you go into a technical side, or when you go as a college student, your primary goal will be, how should I end my career and how should I land in a job? So there are different problems coming up in the life. So how do you want to find a solution? That is what you are going to take away. And if you come into a professional life, if you are in a job, how am I going to succeed in my job? How do I go to a next job? Or how should I compete in my current job? So this is a very, very interesting topic and very knowledgeable topic where you find a solution to see how you can develop your skills around design thinking in both personal as well as professional life. Everyone in this world has a problem, and how you are going to drive towards the solution for this. Can you move on to the next slide, Karthik? Okay. What are you going to take away from this session? After this 1 hour of session, what I want you to know, or what will you learn, or what will your brain be tuned? As I said, the problem is there everywhere. Given the opportunity to view a problem from a different perspective. So if in case you are facing a problem today, how are you going to differ the problem look, or how are you going to differentiate the problem, and how are you going to find the solution? Second thing, and investigate the problem and find a root cause. There is a problem which can have a temporary solution, but temporary solution is not a decision thinking problem or decision making process to solve a problem. You need to go in depth, find the root cause of what is causing the problem, and find a permanent solution. So basically you are eliminating your problem, one of the problem. So that is where you are going to learn about. Third point is a very key point, how you are going to put or apply your innovative thinking and create this problem solving. So how you want to differentiate from others and how you are going to solve this problem. So that is where again a key thing comes. Then the final outcome, the problem might be personal to you. So the outcome is you are satisfying yourself. If the problem you are facing with someone, then how you are going to satisfy him, or how is he happy with you in finding the solution for the problem. So this is going to be a more effective and informative session. Again, I repeat you, if in case there is any doubt, if in case there are any challenges, or if in case you want to point something, please feel free to unmute yourself and please throw your questions, or please post it in the chat box so that I can address you at any point of time. So I hope you're clear on what you're going to learn away today and what you're going to take away from this session and how it is going to be success for everyone. It's up to you. I begin the session here right now. Kathy, can you move on to the next slide? Okay, what is design thinking? It's a very, very simple step. Design thinking is a structured process to find solutions to complex human problems or professional problems. It is a problem-solving approach that focuses on users and their emotional needs while experiencing a different product or a service. Let me take a pause here again and again come back to see if there are any questions that you need to address. Okay, moving on. As I said, you're going to find a solution to handle the problem. Explore the alternatives, because once you have a problem, there can be a solution in plan E, there can be a solution in plan B. So there are different ways that you need to see how you can solve the problem. Third thing is, when you are looking to solve a problem for other people, or when you are working in a team and you want to find a problem for the entire team, you need to identify the context, culture, and look for a solution. You cannot say your own idea is better. There can be an idea from your teammate. There can be an idea from your colleague. So how do you want to get into the context and culture and look out for a solution? That is where you bring your collaborative skills. That is where you develop your communication skill and influencing others. Because if in case you do a project, your final year student is doing a project. He does a project with around 3 to 4 individuals. And what do? You take a project, you find a solution for it. So the solution, when you bring out the solution, the idea can be different from you to your colleague who is helping you in the project. So that is where you need to see how you can develop the culture, or you can develop the context of the problem, how you can collaborate with you. Where I say collaborate is basically engaging your teammates, engaging your peers, engaging your colleagues, and how you look out for solutions. The key thing is, the point is innovation. How you bring your innovation, or how you are thinking differently, and how you are bringing a solution. I can tell you one example. If in case you go to, you are sitting in your college canteen, and you have your lunch, and after your lunch you don't see water coming in the tap, you want to wash your hand. The temporary solution, you can go to the next tap and you can wash your water and go. That is one of the way to solve a problem. But are you finding the real solution out here? No. Because this problem is solved for you. You are going to a near tap. You are going to wash your hand and just go and pass by. But when I say root cause analysis, that is nothing but you go into the canteen to see why the water is not coming into the tap. What is the problem behind it? How am I going to solve it? So what do? You just go one step back. You go into the supervisor or the manager of that particular cafeteria and speak to him. Why is the water not coming? What is the background behind it? Is there any block in the water? Do you need to replace something? So that is where you start to think. That is where you start to analyze these solutions. That is where you point out, you identify the opportunities, how I can come out for a solution in this. So this is basically a design thinking. I have explained you in a very layman language with giving a very layman example to find a solution for a water not coming in a tap. So there are plan A, you can do go to a next stop and next tap and wash and go. But the plan B is looking for a root cause analysis and finding the permanent solution for that water coming in the tap. Karthik, can you go into the next slide? Okay, there are stages of design thinking. When I say thinking, if it is a personal problem, you have your own step, you have your own ideas, you have your own solutions. But when you look into a professional way, there are different ways to define the problem and how do you arrive at the solution. The first step is called as the empathize. The second is called as define. The third is called as ideate. The fourth is prototype. And fifth is the testing or the implementation. Coming on to point by point on how do you want to do a stage of a design thinking. Emphasis is nothing but for whom you want to solve the problem. Identifying the culture of the people whom you want to do. If I go back to the example that I gave to see how why the water is not coming in the tap. So whom you are going to solve the problem? You are going to solve the problem for yourself and for the people who are sitting in the cafeteria who are going to come next and who are going to open the tap. So basically you are finding the solution for a lot of people who are using that particular cafeteria to see how you are going to solve the problem. Second thing, define. So what do you want to solve? What's the problem? So now the water is not coming into the tap. So how do you want to solve? What's the problem? Basically, you are going to analyze the problem. You are going to analyze the, why is water not coming into the tap? What is the root cause behind it? How you are going to, what is, why I am going to do it? So that is called as the define. Three, ideate. Ideate is nothing but an imaginary steps or a plan. You are going to plan. You are going to identify the steps how I'm going to solve the problem. So the first step, what you're going to do, you're going to reach out to the manager of the cafeteria and just see the water is not coming into the tap. May I know the reason why it is not coming? Should we call a plumber? So you plan a step how I'm going to solve this problem. You can definitely report to a manager and go, but that is not the way you to solve a problem. That is you. That depends upon the time. Because if in case you have time, you go. You don't have time, you just go to report to the manager and you might go. But if in case you have a project and you have dealing an end-to-end process, then definitely you need to see what are the plans I'm going to take to solve the problem. The fourth one is a prototype. Prototype is nothing can be what can be the solution. Okay, now you see what are the steps. Then you identify, okay, this is the solution. Okay, there is a blockage over here. So if in case I do this, I can do it. You call a plumber and he's saying, okay, sir, you can replace this. Madam, you can do this. Then these are definitely a skeletal design. So this is where you find the solution. You start finding the solution for the problem. The fifth point is just the test. Okay, once the solution is defined or delivered, then obviously the solution. Solution is nothing but the execution. Okay, now the problem is solved. Now the water is coming on the tap. That's it. So this is a very simple example or in a very layman language, I have covered all these stages of design thinking. The first step is emphasize, define, ideate, prototype, and test. So if I go and apply this in a practical solution or in a professional solution, emphasize. What is emphasize? tomorrow you go and work in a software company or a product company, your stakeholder, your client or your manager is saying that I want to put a new application, put a new app in my Play Store. So how you are going to develop it? So first, whom you are going to work? You are going to work for a client who wants to develop an application or an app in a Play Store, and he wants those particular features. So this is emphasis. So now you know the user who has given you the problem. So for example, today Samsung is coming and telling you, you give you an app in my Play Store to see how it is working. Define. So what do you want to solve? Solve is nothing but the problem. So what has the Samsung given you? Samsung has given you a task to do an application in their mobile. So what do? You form a team and then you start to plan the steps. How do you want the app to be? Or what are the requirements from the user, and how I am going to work on the application? What are the requirements? So the first step can be a sign-in page. Like a Google, if you go into any account in your application store, you see a sign-in page. So this is how the user looks like. Okay, Samsung has given me a task that I need to do an application. So the first step should be a sign-in. Okay, then the sign-in is done. Then what is the next step? So this is how you plan, how you prepare the process to show the app to your client. Prototype. Prototype is nothing but a skeletal design. So okay, after 2 weeks, you have a call with Samsung and they are saying, sir, I have given you a task to prepare an application. Can you show me the steps, what you are doing, or what is the exact stage of the process? So what do? You show your skeletal design. So this is your first page. You have a sign-in. So if you go into the second page, you can see what are the features in there. So that page shows the shopping cart. Fourth page shows the payment option. So this is a simple example. You show your skeletal design. Then your client will give you a lot of suggestions. I want like this. I want this to be like this. Can you replace this A to B? Can you replace this? Can you add this feature? So you get a feedback from the client saying that they want to add in or enhance these kind of things into the particular application. Then what do? You collect all the feedback, and then again you go and you deliver the application. Then finally, what do? Testing. So once everything is ready, you go and test it. How does it work? Does it really meets the expectation of your stakeholder? Is it going a complete smooth process? Is there any hitches in it? Is there anything that we need to rectify? So this is a very, very clear example on how you want to do it on a professional life. I hope you are clear in it. Can I take a pass and see if there is any question coming over? Okay. I think there are no more questions. Karthik, can you move on to the next slide? Next slide, please. Okay. So I will take you with case studies here. These are the number of these are the repetitive case studies that I usually get, because when I do some sessions with college, a lot of people ask me, how do I get employed after graduation? Can you give me a design thinking process? So this I have taken as a live case study. So the first step I will take. So I believe there are third year and final year students. So please take this session, or please take this slide very carefully. Please watch this slide very carefully, because this is definitely going to help you when you end your graduation and how do you start your job search. So first step is prioritize your interest and field of work. That is where your personal, this is a more of a personal attitude that you are taking. This is more of a personal stages of thinking. After your 4 years, or when you are in the third year, you definitely should have an empathize on your interest and your field of work. For example, if you are an electrical engineer, you might show some interest on motor or some engines or some controller, something you will have a develop your interest. So that is your interest of area, and this is where you want to work. So what do you do after your graduation or in the final year graduation? You need to form a resume. What is a resume? Resume is nothing but your curriculum vitae or a two-page document that shows what are your strengths, what are your opportunities, and what are your passionates about. A star format CV. Star is nothing but a situation, task, action, result. So when you prepare your resume, you need to cover all these 4 points in your CV. The situation, task, action, and result. So how do you want to write a resume in a star format? So for example, you do a project in a final year, because when you prioritize your interest, obviously your project should be or can be in the area of interest. So if you have a very good interest in motor, then what will you do? You will try to see whether I can find a project in my specific area of interest in MOTAS, and then you execute the project accordingly. So the next step when you do is when you prepare a CV, when you prepare a star format CV, obviously you will prioritize your points into that particular prioritization. So situation is nothing but what is the project all about? What is it going to do? Then the task, what are your areas? What are you doing for that project? What are you going to contribute? What are your skill sets you are building around that particular project? The action, what is the action that you have taken? Because now you know what is the project, you know what you are going to do, and then the action, how you are doing it. What are the skill sets you are applying? What are the core behaviors that you are bringing into that particular thing? Then the result. So how does it succeed? How does you overcome that particular task? How do you win as a team? That is nothing but the star. Situation, task, action, result. So every point you put in your CV should go into a star format CV. Because normally when I sit in a hiring process with freshers, I see people putting C++, Java, motoring skill. It doesn't look good. To be very frank, as a hiring manager, I will not hire a person who is putting that points in the bulletin. I want the people to show, even if it is a 1 or 2 point, what is the situation, what is the task, what is your action, and what is the result that you have implemented. So even if you are putting 3 bulletin points in your resume, it should cover all this particular point. Okay, then comes the next process. You have a very good resume with you. It's a very good star format CV. You have a very powerful CV, in fact, what I can say. Then what is the next step? Process of networking. Because when you have a network, you need to network and you need to float the resume to different people. You start to develop your networking skills. Networking can be your alumni connect. You can reach out to people. You can do a market research in Google to see what are the jobs that I'm getting or what are the companies that can suit me in an area of interest. And the other thing that I want to suggest is nothing but a networking is LinkedIn. I don't know how many people are using LinkedIn now, but if in case you are not doing it, I request everyone to create a profile in LinkedIn. LinkedIn is a very, very powerful tool to network and land in a job nowadays. LinkedIn is nothing but a professional tool where you can create your resume or where you can replicate what you have in your resume as a very open forum. So when you build your profile in LinkedIn, automatically what do you do is you start to connect with the people. For example, if you want to work in a product development company and if you have your star format resume developed in a product based curriculum or a product based skills, then obviously what do you do? You try to see what are the companies that have my kind of a skill set, or what are the companies that can hire my skill set people. So obviously you start to connect through LinkedIn, because in LinkedIn you can connect with a lot of professionals. If I say you want to go to an Oracle, which is a product-based company, then what do? You go and send the request to connect with people who are working in that particular company. You try to connect with those particular company. I am sure if you connect with 100 people, at least 1 or 2 people will connect with you, or they might accept your request. Then what do? You start to network with them, or you start to interact with them, showing, I have a good resume. My area of interest is this particular. See, can I have any opportunity in your particular company? At one point, they might say no. 10 people might say no, but you don't know. Anyone might have your opening and they might say yes. Then that is where your next step starts. So now what, you have got a gate open. You have an open gate to do an interview. Then what do? You're going to prepare yourself. You're going to prepare for your interview. So how you are going to prepare? So you go into the Google, you see what are the questions. If I'm going to represent a fresher, what are the interview questions? How I'm going to prepare my aptitude test? How I'm going to prepare my group discussions? How I'm going to develop my communication skill? It's very simple, because I'm also a candidate like you who has come from a very rural background. And there are steps that you can do, or you can think to develop your communication skill. Just go into one calm room. Close your door, stand in front of a mirror, speak out, speak for 10 minutes. The first question is, can you define about yourself? What are your strengths? So speak in front of mirror. Just speak loudly. First time you will struggle. Second time you will struggle. Don't get disappointed. Don't get embarrassed. Basically, you need to keep keep on practicing. That is where you develop your skill. Any skill you practice gets developed. So now you are sitting in front of you are in a closed room in front of a mirror. You are presenting yourself. Automatically your tongue start rotating. Automatically your communication gets improved. So this is where you develop your interview preparation skills for your interview. And then next day when you are going to an interview, you are going to be properly neatly dressed, full shave, go prepared. And I'm sure it is not going to be you only be there. There will be 100 plus people. But that is where you need to differentiate from others. You have a very good resume. You have a star format resume. You have networked with the people. You have an influence over there. Okay, you have prepared well for the interview. So automatically it brings your confidence. Automatically you are confident to succeed. So then you go and in front of the hiring manager, if you sit and present yourself, I am sure you will be succeeded. If one or two interviews might go the other way, but definitely I'm sure you have laid the foundation well and you are going to succeed very quickly. So keep your hopes alive. So this is a very, very simple process on how do I get employed after graduation, because that is a thousands of questions that might run in a lot of third year and final year students. Please make a very clear note of this. This is how you want to succeed, how you want to differentiate from others. Today, lakhs and people are coming out of the engineer colleges and you're going to compete with lakhs of people. But obviously there should be some differentiating factor that will put you into your advantage from where you start building your career. So please make a note of it and please feel free to interact. Please feel free to unmute yourself and post any questions if in case you have before I go into the next slide. Karthik? Okay. I'm coming into the live case study too. This might be an interesting case study for electrical and electronics engineering people. So I will not go much in depth of this because it has got a little bit of technicality in it. So just giving a background, again, another example of a design thinking, the first step. Here, what you are going to do, you are going to develop a hybrid electric vehicle for a client. So obviously, who is your stakeholder? Yeah, stakeholder can be from a fuel company, fuel motor company who wants to develop a hybrid electric vehicle, or it can be a particular client who is very much focused on hybrid electric vehicle only. So the second step is defined. Defining is nothing out of the listing down the process. What is the process? Process is very simple, or if in case you look out at a very technical prospect, it's a very complicated process. You need to drive a internal combustion engine to a BLDC motor, brushless DC motor, which is basically nothing but conversion of a fuel vehicle into a electric vehicle, because this is a trend that is coming up in the market as you see the growth of electric vehicles in the market. And how do you want to make the process? The process is nothing but conversion of a IC engine to a BLDC engine. BLDC engine is nothing but an engine that is supporting the battery and the inverter for a hybrid vehicle, which can sustain the similar power of a IC engine or your bike or something like that. So very normal step of ideating the process is nothing but synchronous motor, which is powered by the DC motor, which runs through an inverter in reverse switching power, which produces electricity in the form of alternating current to drive each phase of the motor through a closed loop controller. Prototype is nothing but once you have these brushless DC motor ready, how you want to test it. Testing is nothing but how you see whether the DC motor that you have prepared has the adequate power to support the battery, the durability, and how it is working. How does it compare? How do you compare this motor with the IC motor and things like that? Whether it is running at the good speed of your vehicle, because today if you take a petrol bike and if you go, it goes at 80 kilometers per hour, or it even goes around 100-120. So to what extent is your motor supporting, whether it can be operated at high speed? How durability? Because now the market is at the preset mind is everyone needs to buy a two-wheeler, which is a petrol engine. This is a preset mind. So how you are going to change the preset mind? So the durability check, the efficiency check. So there are different types of checks that you need to perform to see how the electric vehicle is performing on the road. And finally, the execution, where you see whether you have met the expectations of your client, because he has given you a very hectic task. He has given a very complexity task of a developing an electric vehicle from a fuel vehicle. So are you meeting all the challenges of your client? Whether your end product is meeting the expectations, whether your electric vehicle can deliver what IC engine developed vehicle meets. So those are particular things that you need to see. So the challenges here is, yes, they're expensive. The DC motors are always, the BLDC motors are expensive, and we don't know about the lifespan still. Again, in emerging markets like India, we are very much, lazy to put the charges of this battery, the life cycle of battery. We don't have proper charging stations, the durations, because the newly invented electric vehicles, they run up to four hours, 3 hours. So there are definitely challenges in it. Then again, the recycling thing is also a big challenge. How do you want to dispose this e-waste? So there are challenges, and this cannot be sorted out immediately. Definitely our research team or the core team is working behind it to see how successfully we can take out the emissions and bring the electric vehicle in the market. So here I have touched this example again to see how you can cover all these stages of design thinking and how you succeed the solution to bring electric vehicle in the market. Can you move to the next slide, Karthik? Okay, now I believe you are clear on the process or on the stages on how does design thinking works. Then I'm going to take how do you want to develop your skills behind in design thinking? How do you want to design your innovative thinking skills? Because once you have a problem, you have a solution. When you arrive at a solution, how innovative are you? Innovation is nothing but a process which is replicating the old model to find a solution. A typical example is advertisement. Yeah, advertisement can be shown for 3 minutes. That same advertisement can be shown for 3 seconds. That is where the innovation comes in. Doing something new or doing something old in a new way. This is a very simple process. So what I would suggest is, how do you want to develop your innovation skills? There are 3 types of innovation: product innovation, process innovation, business model innovation. Product innovation, I can say the air parts which you see on the diagram. If I remember, when I was 20 years back sitting in the Kalasalingam College, we used to have the Walkmans. We used to have batteries for Walkmans. We used to put it in the tape recorder, the Walkman sets, put a cassette, and then we put the headset for that, and we do it. But today, you have a beautiful mobile, and then you have a good pad. Ear pad, which just put it and just go around it. So this is a product innovation. Process innovation is nothing but how do you succeed? If you look at the companies, the top companies in the market, how are they improving the process? The quality checks, they do a lot of quality checks. If there are errors that are doing, so for example, if you do a project for client and you are facing a lot of errors, and your client is not happy, then you bring a process innovation. So what do I need to do? Do you need to put a quality check controller to see how the quality is maintained? So this is kind of a process innovation. Business model. Again, you can say today a lot of things are in online. Swiggy, Zomato, Amazon, Flipkart. These are all a kind of a business model where you don't want to go out, step out to a market, and they bring to your home and they deliver it. So this is a kind of a business model innovation. So how do you start innovative thinking, or what are the skills you need to develop? Basically, when you start to think, your innovative skill bonds over there. It is nothing but creating something every day. Putting your think process behind it. As I said, the first example, how do you solve the issue on a tap which doesn't have water? So that is where you start to think on a different way. You are not thinking on a temporary solution, whereas you are start to think to find a permanent solution. So those are the various ways that you start developing your skills. Because you are identifying the solution. You are not going with one solution, you are listing down the process so that there is a plan A, plan B. Putting out the right questions, because once you have your ideas, then You need to see whether what I'm going to achieve is right or wrong. So bringing the right questions. Again, innovation doesn't bond with you. It can come out when you start to interact. If you see TV, there are a lot of innovations that you can just put one step behind. If you go, you can see a lot of innovations behind it. Any advertisement has a lot of innovation. Basically, you need to think on what concept you are going to solve or what concept they are going to deliver and just bring out the innovation in it. Karthik, can you move on to the next slide? Okay. Skills to develop. As I covered things earlier, innovation is nothing but a thinking, analyzing, and performing, or I can say executing. You are making, starting to think, making the commitment. You are bringing the what path I'm going to do or what are the ways I'm going to do this thinking. You have a problem and how I'm going to achieve the solution. You have a goal in mind, looking at the success, how it is going to be, and then you're going to execute it. So just note down the up 3 points that is highlighted in the top. Think, analyze, and perform. That is where you need to see how you want to develop your innovation skills. Basically, the first step is thinking, analyzing it, performing it. Analyzing can be your personal way of analyzing. It can be a data in front of you where you can analyze and see how do you can you achieve an output. So those are the ways you need to see. And again, I would like to stress a point here. Innovation doesn't stop at one part. It's like a marathon. It will take on years. If in case there are some different projects or different complications that you have, it doesn't stop at a single point of time. Basically, you need to have your opportunity or you need to learn your thinking skills. That is where you succeed. You need to think and learn. That is where you develop your skills. Karthik, can you move on to the next slide, please? Karthik, next slide. Karthik? Yep. Thank you. So I don't want to touch upon this slide because these are the success stories, what we see on a daily life today, how these companies have succeeded in their product innovation or a process innovation or a business knowledge innovation. We have various examples. If you go into each one of your example, for example, if you take Amazon, if you just go and start thinking how they succeeded, you will identify the process. You will define how they have come, and then you will see automatically how they have executed. So these are various companies which I have pointed out here. There might be different other companies as well, but how you can use it, you just want to see. You don't see Amazon as a shopping app. If you see Amazon on how they are innovative, how they succeeded, obviously you will start to learn behind the process how they have won the Indian market. Obviously, if you look like 5 years back, when this companies like Amazon came into the Indian market in retail space, they said, no, we will not move from our nearby shops. We will buy everything there only. This will not succeed. But today, they are the revolution. Big basket. Again, every individual in apartments or big complexes in cities depends upon big basket daily. So these are types of innovation. These are the ways that they have succeeded. So you need to learn from these companies. You just don't look like a companies as a client. You look like a company you are working. You need to see, I am working in Big Basket. How have I succeeded? Then obviously you will go one step behind and see how they have succeeded, how they have progressed in the backspan of around 5 years time, how they have succeeded, what are the steps they have brought, what are the ways of thinking they have put to succeed in the market today. So these are the ways that you should think and develop your innovative skills in design thinking. Can you move on to the next slide, Karthik? Okay. I think I have covered the syllabus over here, but I would like to stress upon a few things, especially during this pandemic that everyone is facing, to see how you want to succeed. It can be in your professional skills as well as in your personal skills. But as a professional with around 18 years of experience, I would like to stress upon few points, which I think these are the key skills or mantras to succeed. The first important skill, especially for people who are coming out in a graduation from rural villages like me and you, the key thing that you want to improve is your communication skills. As I said earlier, communication skills doesn't come in one day or 2 days. It is a continued process. You need to start preparing it. The first step is just go into a room, close the room, stand in front of a mirror, start speaking. Start speaking loudly. The voice should come out. Your tongue should rotate. Your tongue should get the catch of the word. For example, again, if in case you have a very complicated word that you want to pronounce, if you spell or if you memorize that in your mind, it will not work out. You need to practice it by spelling it out. You need to practice it out in front of a mirror. Your tongue, you are developing your language skills. How do you want to repeat this? Take a paper. Daily, there is a paper. There are online papers, there are offline papers. You have taken the Hindu paper. What do you need to do in the morning? Just take the Hindu paper, go into a room, close it, start reading it loudly. That is where you start your communication skill. That is where you develop your English speaking skills. Second, presentation skills. This is another big area where the people coming from rural colleges face a big challenge, presentation. Tomorrow, when you stand or go for an interview, you are going to compete with a graduate who has come from a city college. So that is where you need to stand out, presentation. How do I want to present? He might be dressed up beautifully. He might have gone to his, facials or the parlors and he come in. But that is where you need to see how I want to present myself. With the existing availability, how should I present myself? The first impression. That is where you need to see. Time management. Everything is bound to time. You go for an interview, they allocate the timing. You need to, you have a scheduled slot, 10:30 to 11:30. You need to be on time. That is where your first impression comes out. After your presentations, you be prepared, need to come on time. Collaboration. So once, that is a very key thing, collaboration. Collaboration is nothing but working with your co-colleagues or your peers. That is where you see how I am capable. That is where you understand your strengths and weaknesses. Because in your, if you work in for a project with five people, you know what the other people's weaknesses. But you need to go one step back and see what is my strength when I work with five people. What is my weakness when I work with five people? List it down. Then you see what are the ways I should develop to develop my weakness. So that is very true. Patience, adaptability. You need to adapt. You might think I will work only in cities, but tomorrow you might land up in a job in a refinery or a place which doesn't have what is your expect or what are the expectations. So that is where you need to start adapting. Your adaptability is again a very key thing. Flexibility, how you are flexible. You should not say I will work only this, I should only learn this. Keep your options open. As a graduate, you need to always keep your option open, because if you want A, you might end up in B. You should not be disappointed. You need to be more flexible to adapt that B also. That is where you will learn your collaborative skills, your patience skills comes up. Thinking, this is what I've been talking about for this last half an hour minutes. Thinking, your design thinking skill, critical thinking, how I'm going to solve a problem. Problem, as I said, can be in your personal life or can be in your professional life, but how I'm going to solve it, or what are the steps I'm taking to solve the problem. Initiative, you need to take initiative. When once you end up in a job, you should not think, okay, I have ended up in a salary of 25,000, I am fine, let me remain calm. Everyone will. No, it's not stopping over there. You need to start taking initiatives. You need to drive it. That is where you need to show your develop your or you develop your leadership abilities. Tomorrow, if you work with 10 people and if every 10 and if in case you want to prove out of 10, initiative and driveness is where you succeed. In 10, you need to see how I'm going to be the number one. How I'm going to lead from front. How I'm going to drive this team. So that is where you develop your leadership team. And finally, be positive and be motivated. Can you move into the next slide, Karthik? Okay. Everyone is going through a very tough situation. This COVID is not going to end anytime now. I know there are final year students who has completed your graduations right now, or who will be completing this year. There is a lot of challenges because the companies even which has recruited has put down or halted their process to hire them back. So definitely these are the options that you can think of. The first step is a part-time engagements. So if you have some loans, if you have taken some educational loans, and if you want to close this, even if you don't land up in your job, your expected job after your career, after your profession, you should think of your part-time engagements. You should try to see how I can go and work and at least start closing my loans. or how I can overcome my commitments. Think of part-time engagement, but don't make that as a permanent thing. Your goal is different, but this is only a part-time engagement you are starting to engage. If in case you are healthy, rich, and if you have your own business, which is driven by your parents or your relatives, start assisting them. Because own business definitely is going to help your parents might feel very happy because your son is going to come and take it. So just try to frame it, or you can go and assist them. It can be farming also. There are a lot of opportunities. If in case you are from a wealthy background and if there is a good family business, then obviously you should go and support it. If you are affordable and if in case you are financially capable, then try to upgrade your education. Don't stop only with BE. There are different online courses where you can develop your skills around it and upgrade your educations. Key thing, always keep your job search on. Do not lose hope, because this is not the end. This pandemic will come to an end very soon. There are lot of opportunities in this market. So keep your job search on, even though if you are in a part-time job or something, because that is where you will be succeeding in life. So you have your ambition, you have your inspiration, you have your goal. So keep your job search on and start running. And another key thing is, again, don't fall to this fake recruitment or agents, because there is a lot of scam going in this market today. When the technology goes up, there are lots of opportunities and there are a lot of negatives as well. So don't fall into this kind of traps. You might receive an email saying, you give me 2,000, 5,000, I will give you a job in Dubai or Singapore. Don't fall into these kind of fake recruitment, because these are completely a scam, online scam that is happening. So be very precaution, be alert. If in case you have any doubt, talk to your staffs. You have very good advisors sitting in your college, like Karthik, Kanan, sir. So talk to them. Definitely, they will also guide you in the right way. And finally, key thing is, an idle mind is devil worship. Keep yourself busy. Keep yourself engaged. Keep yourself fit, because you are the absolute pillars of your family. You are in a very good college. You are in a very good graduation. You need to be positive. You need to be motivated. You need to be a pillar for your family. If in case someone is feeling demotivated, you should talk to them and keep them motivated. At the end of the day, personal relationship is very, very, personal bonding should be very strong when you be interacting with your friends or parents or your relatives. Even they, if they lose their hope, you need to be supportive to them. Karthik, can you move on to the next slide? I think I have given a very good motivation over here. So the key takeaways of this session, even after your career, your learning is not going to be over, because your journey begins after you learn only. Be a lifelong student, be adaptive, as I say, be flexible. In your job, you will start learning. Even though if you earn money, again, your learning should continue. Be prepared. Do what you like, love what you do. Be yourself, don't try to be copy from others. You might take inspirations or you might take aspirations from them, but be yourself. Don't try to go in the wrong path. Life is very, very, very stressed and very heartful. College life is a very funny part. You get good friends over there, but when you come into the real life and when you see the world behind it, it is not the way that you see from the college or what you learn in this 4 years of graduation. When you grow, obviously, try to motivate people around you, because that is a very key thing. Because if you want to succeed, the people around you should also be strong enough to motivate you and bring to it. Be a good storyteller. Share always your positives. There are always, life has always positives and negatives. Take your positives. Share your positives, because it can be useful to people like a few brothers and sisters. So take off your positives, share your positives. If there are negatives, try to see how you can learn from negatives. If there are pure experiences, try to see what is the learning that you can take from it and see what are the process. Put on your design thinking process and see how you can succeed from negatives into a positive. Final thing, push yourself, because there is nothing, there's no one else is there going to do for you. Everything lies on you. Be positive and happy. So I would like to unmute here. Please let me know again. I'm stressing. I'm open to questions and answers. Please feel free to post your questions.
Yeah, students, you can put it in a chat box also. I can read your questions.
Please let me know your feedback. How do you find this session? I hope I'm not taking your time. So, Karthik, any suggestions from your end? Anything that I want to talk about?
Oh, yeah, it's a very fine and very informative session, and you covered almost all the design thinking process, and you have given enough tips and motivation for the students to succeed in their life.
Thank you.
Sir, thank you, sir, for sharing your career experience. Your example, case studies, and the way of explaining enlightening to us, sir. And moreover, we learn how to tackle problem and see better situation. I mean, better solutions, sir. Especially your star former concept is more informative and effective, sir. Surely we will follow these tips, sir. It is really eye-opening session for us, sir. And once again, thank you, sir, for spending your valuable time with us.
Thank you very much, students. Everyone is going through a tough phase in life. So please stay positive. Don't fall into the trap of the negatives or the fakes. Proposals that are circulating in the media. Don't look into it. Life is very big. Don't think of it. You be more precautious. You wear mask. You wear put up on your hand sanitizers and you enjoy your life. If you think this is a pass of the world or this is a pass of the world, then you are not going to move ahead. Life should go, whatever it is. Please focus on your plans. Please focus on your vision. Please focus on your goals. And please proceed. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. I request Vignesh to deliver the vote of thanks.
Good afternoon to all. It is my pleasure to deliver vote of thanks to one and all gathered here. In this occasion, it is my great privilege to thank our resource person, Mr. K.V. Vinod Kumar, Contracts Manager, Fuel and Lubricant Value Chain, ExxonMobil India Private Limited, Bangalore, for accepting our invitation and delivering the very informative presentation to all the students. I thank you, sir. I thank all the participants for attending this inauguration function of professional societies. I also thank our principal, Dr. L. Ganesan, sir, and co-curricular activities coordinator, Dr. K. Vijayalakshmi, and HOD of Tripoli, Dr. S. Kannan, for encouraging us to conduct this inauguration function of professional societies. Also, I thank our department technical association in charge, Dr. K. Karthikeyan, Associate Professor of Tripoli, IEEE Student Branch Counselor, Mr. A. Arun Kumar, Assistant Professor of Tripoli, and IE Student Chapter in Charge, Mrs. S. Jayanti, Assistant Professor of Tripoli, for coordinating these events. I once again thank all the students for attending this inauguration function, and we are expecting your participation in future events organizing by our professional societies and technical association. Thank you very much for giving me the opportunity for delivering vote of thanks. Thank you.
Thank you, Vignesh. A special thanks to our faculty members and our college management and the head of the department to arrange a worthwhile session for us. I thank everyone in the patience of participating in the inauguration function. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am.